everybody, to Cunningham Piano Company. I am really excited about this evening. We're going to hear, this is a way for us to reach back into the Romantic era and hear what musicians perhaps heard when they wrote their music. And musicians here will have an experience that they may have never had before, truly. Here at Cunningham Piano Company, we've been chosen by folks around the world to do restoration to an instrument to make it as if it was brand new when that piano came out of the factory. So we will not change scale design. We'll honor the scales. We'll honor the design of a particular instrument. And for the most part, that's what we did with this instrument. There were a couple of changes. For instance, we did change the action a little bit, because if not, it would be very, very disturbing for a 20th century, 21st century musician to play it. It still doesn't play. Does this play like a brand new piano? Yeah, close? Okay. Well, close, but not exactly. Not exactly, if you say that's true. Sure, whatever I said.
I can't say anything without
talking. Okay. So it still is, and I had some comments from some players that, it still is not exactly like a brand new instrument, and that's true. But it also is not an 1860 action. So we did make some changes so that you would feel comfortable, and so that the owners of the piano would feel comfortable. The story behind this instrument. Now, we do go all over the nation and buy instruments for us to restore. And in the past year, we've restored instruments for Indiana University of Bloomington, for Westminster Choir College. Since I've been here, we've actually done a few instruments for Temple University. So a few of the older pianos that you have there were worked on by us many years ago. I don't think anyone here was born, especially in Bloomington. But I'm teasing. This evening, we have a very special instrument. This was sent to us by a family, and they happen to be here. The names are right here. Thank you for coming, guys. So we're doing their piano, which has been their family heirloom, so that's really special to us. And we are videotaping, so you will get a copy of this, and who knows, you may never have this amount of really talented people playing your piano ever again. Maybe. What's that?
Unless we wait for the
call. Unless that's right. Okay. So maybe a month from now we'll all meet at the domains. Okay. And enjoy this evening. If you have questions during the evening, I will be around. Afterwards, we're going to serve refreshments. We're excited to say that our refreshments are provided by La Bus, so it's really good stuff. And enjoy the evening. Thank you for coming. Awesome.
We are very privileged to play on a piano like this. The group of students that are here tonight with me are all master's and doctoral students, one honorary, about to be a master's student next year. And we've all been studying performance practice of the Romantic era. And that might not sound as strange as it actually is, because normally performance practice, the way we study it historically, is reserved for things like Baroque music and early classical music. And we kind of think we know how to play Romantic music, but actually there's a lot to learn. And so over the semester, we've been studying letters, we've been learning to dance the mazurka and the waltz and the polonaise, and we've been improvising, which is something that they did much more in those days than we do today. And I think we've all learned a lot from accounts of what it was like to study the Kawashima. So we put together a program, of music that we've been working on over the semester together, and hopefully you'll hear some of what we've learned. And I think a big part of what we've learned is that we should all relax and enjoy the music. And tonight, a concert like this, where you have 11 of us sharing the joy of performing for you, is very special. In our time, we tend to have things like a group that gives a whole recital or a soloist who gives a whole recital. But back in the period that we were studying, we found out that Brahms gave his debut by playing one piece on a program, and that Catherine Hayes, the singer, sang for the Queen of England and sang one aria. So we're all kind of collaborating and sharing this evening, and it's more like what you might find in a living room in the mid-19th century. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
part of the charm of a salon performance is that it's informal. So please feel free to be informal. However, this evening is being recorded, so if you can avoid any unnecessary noise, please do, okay? We're going to start out our second half with the only undergrad in the program. Am I right about that? Yes? 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 Daniel.